Honorable Mr. Akram Chayef, Chair of COFO 24, Your Excellency the President of Sri Lanka, Mr. Maithripala Sirisena, Your Excellency Ambassador Mario Arvelo, Chief of FAO Committee on Food Security, Honorable Mr. Slawomir Mazurek, Undersecretary of State, Ministry of the Environment, Poland, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning to all of you. Allow me to start by extending my sincere gratitude to the Director General of FAO for his kind invitation for me to deliver this statement at this very important event, the 24th session of the FAO Committee on Forestry. I also would like to humble thank to FAO for the warm hospitality accorded to us and to all delegates. I'm delighted that this particular session of COFO, we will explore the contribution that forest can make to the achievement of the Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs. I'm pleased to learn that FAO has just launched a new publication, State of the World Forest 2018, with the main theme, Forest Pathway to Sustainable Development. I congratulate FAO for such timely release of the publication, and indeed, it is worthwhile to discuss the contribution of forests to achieving SDGs and the implementation of Paris Agreement, also with the challenges and opportunities in accelerating progresses. Mr. Chairman, distinguished delegates, the pressure of world population growth and the advance of development affected the environment and natural resources. The 17 goals of SDGs reflect global efforts to control and to recover the environment. Furthermore, continued rapid population growth and the increase of per capita income are accelerating the global demand for and consumption of forest products and services while putting pressure on forests, damage the habitats of endemic species, decrease biodiversity and disturb ecosystem and the function of nature as in regulating life support system, carrier of media, production material, as well as on information function such as for spiritual healing. Indonesia is getting a grip on advancing development while addressing environmental challenges. Our national policies on forest are in line with the objective of SDGs. Mr. Chairman, distinguished delegates and colleagues, let me take this opportunity to briefly highlight Indonesian efforts to achieve SDGs through forestry. Beyond the goals being reviewed by high-level political forum now in New York, namely goals 6, 7, 18, 12, 15, and 17, as you are aware, Indonesia has huge forest area of about 120 million hectares with additional marine conservation area of 5.3 million hectares. About 70% of our forest area are still forested on under forest land cover. They are home to the high biodiversities and consisting of about 19 different types of ecosystem with high level of endemicity. Since the adoption of SDGs September 2015, Indonesia has initiated concrete actions, including linking most of the SDGs target and indicators into the Indonesian National Medium-Term Development Plan, following up the strong convergence between SDGs and 9 priority presidential agenda of President Jokowi Nawacita. The commitment of Indonesia government is achieving SDGs is reflected by Presidential Regulation Number 59 of 2017 regarding the achievement of the SDGs, which consists of economic, social, environmental, and good governance pillars. This particular work is under direction of our Vice President. Our forest policies and implemented agenda are pertinent to the objective of SDGs in terms of achieving goal number 1, no poverty, and 10, reduce inequality. We focus on developing social safety net for poor people through community or village forests. we have about 25,800 out of 80,000 villages located inside or surrounding forest areas. Community forests, covering an area of 1.73 million hectares, have been granted to the 390,000 households, or equal to the effort in lifting 1.2 million people from poverty of about 10 million poor people living inside and surrounding forests. Forests also actualize the meaning of human rights through the recognition of customary forests for the natives, the local native community. For the first time in December 2016, customary forests for local native community were acknowledged formally by our president and continue to be developed to cover about 2.2 million hectares. This also contributes the transform communities living inside and surrounding forest area to be more prosperous citizens. To support the achievement of goal number 3, good health and well-being, we address the planet pollution by planting trees, developing new forests, and will do replanting 400,000 hectares of post-mining areas. These efforts can also reduce greenhouse gases emission through the reduction of deforestation and forest fire prevention through the improvement of peatland governance. We have also been able to provide a better environment by preventing fires. Our effort to reduce land and forest fire has been able to keep reducing up to 168,000 hectares of affected area in 2017 compared to 2.6 million hectares in 2015, leading to the relatively absence of transboundary haze in 2017. We also enforce law to companies as well as individuals who set fires. Since 2015, through strengthened legal measure, administrative sanctions have been vigorously applied in cases where violations were identified. Supervision, monitoring, and sanction imposed in 2016 proved to be quite effective, that there were no longer administrative sanctions issued in 2017 for violation of the law related with forest and land fires. In relation to goal number 8, decent work and economic growth, we focus on forest contribution to the improvement of economic growth through the development of sustainable ecotourism in 45 national parks in Indonesia. Furthermore, we also provide access to material welfare through the provision of forest management rights with sustainability consideration in order to improve food security through agroforestry, agro-silvopasture, agro-silvofishery, and the enhancement of non-timber forest product utilization such as honey and rattan, etc. To support the achievement of goal number 12, sustainable production and consumption, we improve governance, law enforcement, footprint, and traceability of products, among others, through the improvement of timber administration online system and timber legality assurance system. In terms of Goal 13, the climate action, the government of Indonesia ratified Paris Agreement and then incorporated it into the Act Number 16 of 2016 on the ratification of the Paris Agreement to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. The commitment to reducing emissions for greenhouse gases has been reaffirmed in Indonesia's National Determined Contribution, whereby Indonesia agreed 2030 targets for reducing emissions are 29% through its sole effort and up to 41% depending on level of international cooperation. The most significant reduction will be achieved in the forestry sector, with its reduction contributing 17.2% of the nation, 29% in unconditional condition, and 23% in the 41% in conditional reduction. in relation to goal 15, life on land, the related to goal 6 and goal 7, our forest management is vitally supportive to food, energy, and water security with their sustainable utilization. The supply of water energy, such as geothermal and hydropower, requiring good forest cover for their sustainability. Thanks to our concerted effort, Indonesia has successfully reduced the rate of deforestation in the last 3.5 years to around 0.45 million hectares per year, compared to the average deforestation rate of 1990 to 2012 that reached 0.92 million hectares. In halting biodiversity loss, we have strengthened our protected area management and shifted the approach to manage the area to be more collaborative and participatory. Indonesia has also ratified and taken concrete measures to implement a number of agreements related to the Convention on Biodiversity. Furthermore, we focus on preservation of biodiversity and its sustainable utilization. In terms of goal number 17, on partnership to achieve the goal, we lead partnership and interconnectivity and overseas cooperation, such as the agenda of Heart Borneo, engaging Indonesia, Malaysia, and Brunei Darussalam, as well as the management of transboundary watershed between Indonesia and the Democratic Republic of Timor-Leste, and between Indonesia and Papua New Guinea. In addition, we also initiate a cooperation with the Republic of Congo and Democratic Republic of Congo to improve the management of peatland in the Congo Basin with the support from UN Environment Program. We are also preparing the establishment of International Tropical Peatland Center in Indonesia. On the capacity building, I am pleased to inform this session that during the last 3 years, Indonesia has provided fellowship on vocational forestry school and also short-term training on technical forestry for Timor-Leste. Indonesia puts into record the partnership with and generous contribution of the United Kingdom, European Union, Germany, Norway, Denmark, United States, Japan, Republic of Korea, Australia, as well as multilateral organizations, including FAO, UNDP, UN Environment, ITTO, GF, and AFOCO, in promoting sustainable forest management in our country. Mr. Chairman, distinguished delegates and colleagues, certainly I can go on and on in elaborating how forests are critical for Indonesia in achieving SDGs, but due to limited time, I just highlighted that forests are important to the achievement of SDGs. A major shift is taking place in our country toward a new perspective of sustainability. In the past, policies and action were mainly aimed at achieving sustainable forest production. Now, the perspective is shifting toward balancing social, environmental, and economic development values for the benefit of the country and the citizens. We have moved from timber-oriented management into forest landscape management. We have also taken corrective policies to achieve sustainable forest management. Furthermore, we are also aligning forestry policies and regulation with National Vision and Development Plan and with international commitments, including SDGs, Paris Agreement, and CBD. Mr. Chairman, distinguished delegates, with this shifting paradigm, Indonesia expects to take more proactive roles in the international movement to sustain the world forest ecosystem and to support the world agenda on sustainable development. Having learned from protecting forests and emerging environmental challenges, we have to improve our capacity to address the problem, prepare stakeholders to understand the problem better, mitigate the impact, and control the source of the problem. I suppose this also applies in many other countries. In this regard, I would like to invite FAO to support member countries, including Indonesia's effort in achieving SDGs, and encourage our fellow member countries to work together and share knowledge in utilizing their forest resources in achieving SDGs. Let's join hands, work together, and ensure that all are moving in the right direction. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I will end my remarks by informing you all that I will take the opportunity provided by FAO tomorrow to deliver a more comprehensive presentation regarding the new policies in Indonesia and all corrective actions to shift towards a sustainable forest management and the progress that has been made so far. All of this has been documented in the newly publication entitled State of Indonesia's Forest 2018, which I will be delighted to share with you tomorrow in Indonesia's side event, which is scheduled on Tuesday, tomorrow afternoon, at Sheikh Zayed Center. I am pleased to invite you all. Thank you very much for your kind attention, and I wish you all a productive deliberation. I thank you.